when you're deploying changes into any of your environments, whether it's a new release, a configuration change, however you deploy, you always want to make sure that the system still works as expected. From a Dynatrace perspective, we provide you with the so-called Site Reliability Guardian. Now, we've talked about this in previous videos, but I want to go a step further today. I want to show you what is possible and what are some of the best practices in using the Guardian. The ultimate goal, as you can see here on the slide, is automating release validation across multiple critical objectives, ranging from everything from infrastructure, services, security, and so on and so forth. Now, let me make this a little bit bigger here. So first of all, the Site Reliability Guardian comes with your Dynatrace platform. And if you're creating a new Guardian, the Dynatrace team has done a really good job in providing you ready-to-go templates, whether it's around four golden signals, around Kubernetes workload, or even security gates. So you can go with these and immediately get going within minutes. Now, often what we suggest, as you're mature, you may have your own additional objectives that you want to add. So this is when you go with create without a template. I'm going to switch now to a Guardian that we are seeing and also educating on as a best practice. Best practice means I have multiple different dimensions across the different layers of my stack. You can see here, I ran that Guardian multiple times for my version number 1, 2, and 3 of the app that my Guardian is Guardian for me. If I scroll down a little bit, I can actually see the individual objectives, container logs. Container logs is all about, if you hover over, it figures out what's the ratio between the total logs and the logs that have an error warning. Why is this an important objective? When you're making a deployment change, you want to make sure that the ratio of error or warning logs not all of a sudden goes up. So we can use the Guardian to validate this for us. Next thing is pod availability. If you're deploying pods into Kubernetes or any other container orchestration platform, you want to make sure that your pods can actually be deployed and are running. So here, behind the scenes, we're using pod availability, which means the ratio between the desired and the active pods for the workload. What else is there? Service availability. Here, if you're deploying a service and if some load on it, you want to make sure that the ratio of total versus service requests that fail, so for instance, with an HTTP 500, stays stable and stays within an accepted range. Because remember, when you make a deployment change, and all of a sudden you see 500s popping up everywhere, this is not a good sign. What else do we have here? Service performance. This is about a performance objective. If you are deploying a service and you want to make sure that the API endpoints or the endpoints that are used by your UI, they are responding within a timely fashion, you can say, hey, Guardian, I want to validate and make sure that when I make a new deployment or a change, that my performance of my critical API endpoints stays stable, stays underneath the objective that I have. Synthetic availability, a best practice from a Dynatrace side is every time you deploy a critical service, then you want to have a synthetic test. The synthetic test will automatically test the availability, the performance, and it can do complete functional end-to-end testing. So here, with every deployment, I basically say, how are my synthetic tests doing? Because if I have a service and I have synthetic tests running as part of my deployment validation or in production on a continuous basis, then I want to make sure that after a deployment change, the synthetic tests still report everything is available in green. The last thing is service throughput. That's also a really interesting metric. Basically, service throughput looks at a particular time frame and says, do we see the same number of requests that are actually coming in and being serviced by my new deployment? So why is this interesting? If you're making an update, let's say from version 1 to version 2, it's a rolling update. You want to make sure that during that update, your service can still handle the same amount of throughput as before. So with this particular value here, with this particular objective, we make sure to get alerted in case there's any throughput change, right? This would typically indicate any issue during a rolling update. So how does this actually work behind the scenes? I could have given you the Guardian here, but what we have actually done, we've created a notebook that we uploaded to the Dynatrace Playground tenant. So find the link to this notebook in the video description. Again, it gives the overview of what I just mentioned, but it goes a little bit deeper. It actually explains for every single metric, for every single objective that I've just explained. What is this particular objective? Just what I explained earlier when I walked through the Guardian. So for instance, pod availability, it calculates the ratio between the desired and active pods. Now, for all of these, you get a DQL query. Now, this is not just a DQL query that is specific to my particular environment. We've parameterized it a little bit. And the whole thing actually came out of a hands-on training that we've been creating and working on for a while. And in that particular training environment, we are using Backstage to deploy our components, or let's say we're using Backstage as our IDP. When we onboard applications, every application or every workload gets a unique component identifier. And this identifier has the name of default, project name, owner, and stage. And so what you're seeing here is basically DQL queries that you can copy and paste. And then what you need to do is you need to specify project name, owner, and stage as variables in the Guardian. How this works, I'll show you in a second. Now, if you don't have the same naming pattern, obviously feel free to change any of these queries. The point though is make them configurable, leverage the values or the feature of variables so you can use the same DQL query in different Guardians. And then the concept of variables comes in so that every Guardian can then specify its own value for project, for owner, and for stage. Just to show you that really for every single objective, synthetic availability, there's a description, also what the filter is all about, service performance, same thing. Here, the performance objective is about measuring the number of requests that are faster, like in this case, like 500 milliseconds. So it calculates a ratio. If you want to have a different, if you have a different performance objective, obviously just put this in and just modify the query. What else is there? Service availability. We talked about this. Container logs, very important, and also service throughput. All right. So in this notebook, you have everything available that you can just copy paste over, including the description on how the parameters and the filters work. Now, let me show you. Let's go back to the Guardian quickly. So in that Guardian, you can already see one best practice, which is around tags. So if you're creating, if you allow your engineering teams to create their own Guardians, to guard their own deployments, a best practice is to tag them properly. For instance, with for which stage, for which project, for which team is this Guardian for? This allows you to better manage and organize your Guardians. It also helps you with automation. One of the things you see here is notify true. In our setup, we actually have a workflow that gets triggered every time a Guardian is finished. And that workflow actually says, hey, there's a Guardian that is finished. Does the workflow has the tag notify true on it? And if so, the workflow then sends a notification back to that team. Coming to variables, let me go in here and quickly edit this particular Guardian. So you can see here, these are these objectives. Really what I did, I just copy and pasted everything over from my notebook. And in order for these queries to work, now let me go to one of the queries again. Remember that's the backstage name of a component for the pod availability. In this case, I need project name, owner, and stage. And the Guardian has a feature called variables, and you can see them here. So initially, I specified variables. Owner, ownership is very important. Which development team is this? Project name, which particular project is this for, and also which stage. Now, this is the way we are structured it and defined it in our hands-on training. But I'm sure in your organization, you have your own way how to uniquely identify an environment or a stage, however you call it, a team or ownership, and maybe the project name. So do it in a similar way. And then if you have this, then I'm pretty sure you can then use these variables to uniquely identify your workload, your synthetic test, your logs, your namespace, whatever it is, right? And we use this, as I said, for instance, to calculate the number of pods available by querying the number of pods from the, from the component that has the particular backstage label, default, project name, stage, and owner, right? So variables are super, super powerful. Let me go now back, cancel out of here, because I think in the background, I've actually run a new test or a new build, and you can see here now I have 4 results. Earlier I had 3, if you paid attention. One of the things that is also really nice in the Guardian, on the x-axis, by default, it shows the timestamp of the Guardian execution, but you can also change it to any of the values or the keys from your execution context that is passed in. And in my case, I have my version field. So every time I have a new version being deployed from my CI/CD tool, that CI/CD tool is sending an event to Dynatrace. This then triggers my Guardian, and this data is all here, and I can also now analyze my results based on my version. And if I scroll further down, right, you can see all the results. First of all, the whole execution context, these are all the values that are coming in, and on the bottom again, all of these relevant objectives that we specified. Cool. Last but not least, Guardians are great. We have the Guardians here in Dynatrace, but in the end, we want to provide something that is very appealing and easy for developers, that actually kind of flows into the development process that you have in your organization. Now, there might be different tools that you use, but for instance, if you're using a tool like Backstage as your developer portal, then, and so let me just refresh here, because I did, as I said, a deployment earlier. On my service page, on my component page, if I scroll down, we're using here the Dynatrace plugin for Backstage, where I get a direct link to the workload, to the logs. But what we also have here is Dynatrace validations. So these are all the different Guardians that are running. And you can see here, there's the simple node, service team, preprod one, that's that Guardian. With a direct link, I can also click on here and I get directly back to that Guardian. That should be the same result I just had open. Here we go, perfect. Now you may wonder, what about, there's a second one, it's called Validate Observability Availability. That's interesting. Now in my case, if I click on this one, I have specified a central Guardian. I call it a central Guardian for lack of a better term. This central Guardian is a Guardian that validates every time a new deployment comes in, whether this deployment, as you can see here, is producing logs or Dynatrace is capturing logs, and whether Dynatrace is also capturing requests and metrics. So I'm really just using the Guardian as a first mechanism to say, we just deployed something into an environment, and now I have a Guardian across all of my deployments that basically validate, do we have logs that are coming in? Do we have metrics coming in? I can obviously extend it to traces, to security, to any other events, right? So this is a central Guardian that I have. Now, last but not least, not only can we make this data available in your IDP, whether this is your Backstage, whether you use any other IDPs, we can also push this to any other tool. So you may have noticed on the top here, I also have Git open. So in my case, I made a Git commit earlier where I made the change of my deployment from version number 3 to version number 4. And in the end, I get a link to the final result of my Guardian in my Git workflow. So clicking on here, I also get with a single click to my Guardian where I would click on probably if there's a problem, I click on it and then I can see, okay, hey, everything is green, that's great, but if something would be red, what's wrong? Okay, service availability, pod availability, something is wrong, then I can go directly in here. Cool. So to kind of wrap it up, make sure that you're having a look at the notebook. It's called Release Validation Observability Lab Generate 2025. I think I will probably rename this because it's already 2025. This is where we explain every single query that we're using in this best practice guide in our hands-on tutorial, with the DQL queries, with the variables. So hopefully this finds also the explanation. We try to do a good job in explaining why this is an important metric and what it really does and what we want to aim for, okay? So check this out. Also give us feedback. Let us know what best practices you have, right? And with this, I want to go back into a bigger screen here. So keep us posted and hopefully this was useful. Use the Guardian, check out what we have, start with the templates, but then go beyond the templates and use some of the best practices we've had here. Thank you. Cheers.